ship, what a joy divine. Leaning on the everlasting arms, what a blessedness, what a peace is mine. Leaning on the everlasting arms, leaning, leaning, safe and secure from all alarms. Leaning, leaning, leaning on the everlasting arms.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Greetings in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. This is your friend and pastor, Carlo Lord, coming to you from the First Baptist Church of Panama, the Republic of Panama. I trust that you will remember that last week we dealt with the 23rd Psalm, but just part of it. We did not finish all of it. Today, this morning, with the help of God and with your prayers, I trust to give you another part of this tremendous Psalms, the 23rd Psalms. At this time, just join us in the reading of the 23rd Psalms again. Like I said last week, it is well known, it is very familiar to us, but let's take time to read it again this morning, okay? So join us as we read the 23rd Psalm.
Chapter 23. The Lord is my shepherd. I have what I need. He lets me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He renews my life. He leads me along the right paths for his namesake. Even when I go through the darkest valley, I fear no danger, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Only goodness and faithful love will pursue me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord as long as I live.
Thank you. Join me now in prayer. Father, we thank you for this another blessed day that you have granted us with. Father, as we go through again the 23rd Psalm, help us, Lord, to see the depths of it, the truth of it, not just for Bible knowledge, dear God, but that we will apply it to our daily lives and live that life that you will want us to live. Thank you, God, for allowing Jesus to come to this world to die for our sins. Now today we know him as Lord, as the one that is interceding for us at your right hand. Father, this morning, help us to understand the word. Help us to receive it with gladness. Thank you, Lord, for being with us at this hour. Speak to us, Lord, for we listen. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 Okay, here we are, folks. Again, like I said, this morning we continue with the 23rd Psalms. Today we will see what else he is to us as our shepherd. As our shepherd, we had mentioned that he is the keeper of our soul. He is our helper, you know, and other things that we had mentioned last week. Today we are going to begin by looking at Jesus as our shepherd, as our energizer. He is our energizer, as our shepherd also. In verse 3, we read, "He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake." Beloved, as the shepherd tends his flock, so God tends to us. He takes care of us. He gathers us. He gathers even the lamb, that's the young ones. He carries them close to his heart. Now, at times, sheep will walk away from the flock get into trouble in the sense that at times reading about the characteristics of a sheep, I learned that at times they will turn completely over on their backs, unable to get up, to stand again. Now, if the shepherd doesn't arrive on time to rescue that sheep could die. The shepherd is always looking over his sheep. When he realizes that one is missing, he will search for it until he finds it. We, at times, as sheep, having the Lord as our shepherd, even so at times, beloved, we stumble and fall and become so helpless. When we fall and sin, the Lord as our shepherd wants to restore us, just like he did to Peter after the denial. Remember when Peter denied the Lord three times? And after the resurrection, when Jesus was resurrected, it was to that same Peter that failed, that denied his Lord. It was to that same very Peter that Jesus said, "Peter, lovest thou me? Peter, lovest thou me? Peter, lovest thou me?" Three times he asked Peter, "Lovest thou me?" And Peter said, "Yes, Lord, you know I love you." And he said, "Feed my sheep, feed my lambs." Beloved, when we sin, God is ready to restore us back to our feet, to take us off our backs. When we fall flat on our face or flat on our backs, beloved, God is right there as the good shepherd to take us up and restore us back into the rich fellowship. The Bible tells us, beloved, that we, like sheep, have gone astray. We have turned everyone to our own way. But again, God is right there to pick us up, to bring us back if we will repent and come back to him. He's not only our energizer, beloved. He is also our protector. Verse 4, "Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me." Or some versions say, "Thou art with me." Okay? Now listen, we all have our valleys. Somewhere in life's journey, we must all go through the valley. And if you believe that you have not been through a valley, or if you have not been through a valley as yet, be sure of this, beloved. We will one day, or you will one day, walk through the valley of the shadow of death. The Bible tells us in Hebrews 9:27, it's appointed to man once to die, but after this, the judgment. Okay? So, we will one day, rather we want it or not, believe it or not, we will one day walk through the valley of the shadow of death. At times, this valley is walked all by ourselves. That if Christ is not walking with us. When we walk without the shepherd and we begin to face death, or we face death, beloved, we will be alone. So we either walk along with the shepherd or we walk alone without the shepherd. Now, you might remember when we were kids, we thought, there were times we thought that we were big enough to care for ourselves and take care of ourselves. But what happens when there was a thunderstorm? You remember? We will look for safety close to Ma or to Pa or to Grandpa or to Grandma. We will run to somebody that is bigger than us, okay? To protect us and to comfort us. So it is with us at times in life. We feel that we don't need God. We feel that we can do without God. But when we find ourselves up a wall, beloved, when we find ourselves in trouble, when we find ourselves in danger, then we remember that there is a God and we call to that God. Unfortunately, for some of us, it might be too late. Beloved, the only way to be close to God in death is to be close to Him now. Okay? He is our energizer, beloved. He is also our protector, you know. And He's also, beloved, as a shepherd, as our shepherd, He is our helper. Again, the second part of verse 4 tells us, your rod and your staff comfort me. You know, back in the days of David, that's what the shepherd used, a rod and a staff. The rod was used to kind of, protect the sheep from danger, you know, and the staff was used, it was a long stick with a kind of a hook on the end to pull the sheep out of danger or to pull him back to the flock, you know. So I believe today, if we were to kind of paraphrase this thing, this Psalms, you know, perhaps we would say, his gun and his knife comfort me. But because, you know, we like I said last week, we don't have the experience of dealing with shepherd personally, so to speak. But God is our shepherd. Jesus Christ is our shepherd today. And beloved, He protects us. And at the same time, He disciplines us, beloved, as sheep. And we need to understand that without Him, beloved, we will be in very much danger. That's why it is wise for us to stay in the sheepfold, stay in the church, beloved. And when I talk about the church, I'm not talking about the four walls of the building, because the church is not the four walls. The church is not even an organization, beloved. The church is the body of Jesus Christ. And we are the church. We are the church. Stay among God's people. Stay in the church. Stay in the sheepfold. Beloved, it's a blessing to have the Lord Jesus Christ as our shepherd. Okay? So I encourage you this morning, don't walk away from the church. Don't walk away from the sheepfold. Out there, like I said last week, beloved, there are wolves dressed in sheep clothing, and there is a lion walking around seeking who to devour. So be very careful as we go out this coming week, as the Lord permit us to do. Stay close to the shepherd, stay in the sheepfold for His honor and to His glory, and for your own safety. Until next time, God be with you.